they are the most unfortunate, because they know that they can get something good, something nice, something which can be from ultimate benefit for them, and then they don't take advantage of them, of this. Those who are unfortunate, who don't know about this, they may somehow or other they can come in contact with Krishna consciousness, and they may take it up and in this way become fortunate. Last week was here Devamrita Swami, and he was telling us a little bit about his preachings on university. And he was telling about the students and professors, how they, although they know that some things do not bring them happiness, they are not ready to give up. Because they don't have any other goal, they don't know what better they could do in life, so they need to engage in this, what they know, and they hope it will give them happiness. So we are here to go around and to preach to people and to give them some solution, to tell them that there is some other reality, something behind this material world, and something where we can be more happy, where can be some eternal happiness, something completely different. We can give them knowledge, we can give them hope. Otherwise they are completely hopeless. They don't have any hope for any better life unless they get this knowledge. We are here, we have hope. So shall we take advantage of this? This is up to us, how serious we are going to be. But these poor people are without hope. And many times it's happened that people are even tired from material life and they are searching for something, but then they became victims of some pseudo gurus and some false transcendentalists who are very cheap and start giving to people something which doesn't really have ultimate benefit. For example, in my cookery class there is one lady who likes all these spiritualists, everything what is going on. She is attending classes of many different gurus and everything. And she was telling me about one guru. Oh, he's so kind, he's so nice. An example how he's kind and nice is, there is another person, let's call this person B. Person B was deadly sick. She was about to die. And then she came to this guru and guru told her, oh no, you will live. You will not die, this will go away. He gave her blessings to stay alive. And then this poor person B was living in hope that she will not die. Until last day she was thinking that she will stay alive. And I said, okay, you think this is good for her? Yes, this is so good because she didn't want to die. Of course she didn't want to die, no one doesn't want to die. This material body and this dying and changing the body is completely unnatural to the living soul. To the soul is normal to be eternal, to have spiritual body and not to take birth and die and death. So you see, if this person being didn't go to that guru, if she came here, she could get some kind of benefit by knowing if she read Prabhupada's books, she could find out that even if she die, what she will die, she can prepare herself for her future, that there is future after living body. And whatever she can prepare herself to get nice spiritual body, to go in a spiritual world which is completely beyond this material existence, and she can have nice time here. She could get process how to achieve all these things. And she also had one kind of advantage, that she knew that she's going to die very soon. So this could give her so much seriousness. She could be more sincere than many of us who are thinking we have 20, 30, 50 years in front of us. Similar situation happened with Parikshit Maharaj. He knew that he has 1 week to live, so he completely left everything else and dedicated himself to Krishna Katha. He was trying to find out what is the best thing for him to do in this last 7 days. In the same way, this lady, she also could find what would be the best thing to do to prepare herself for the end of the life. And all of this cheating world gave her a hope that she would stay alive. So we can see, these people who are outside, who don't know about Krishna consciousness, they are in a really bad situation. So this could be going out, we are really giving them mercy, but Srila Prabhupada's good, giving them kind of invitation for spiritual world. Because if they read this and take advantage of this process, this can be the best benefit what they're having in their life. And we can see here that Lord Chaitanya empowered every devotee to do this. And this empowerment is coming through the parampara, through Srila Prabhupada and through our gurus. If we, and this empowerment is coming most of the time, empowerments and blessings we are getting in the form of instructions. So in order to take blessing from someone, it's actually mean to take instruction. And then if we are following instructions, doing what they told us, following all regulating principles and doing all this chanting in front of the Lord, taking remnants of his food, going outside and preach, then we can be really empowered to do this. And in the meantime, when we are there, we can do the same that Lord Chaitanya is doing. We can pray to Lord to get some mercy, to help us and protect us. Maybe we can have 5 minutes of discussion if there's any question or comment on this.